All right. So, as promised to some of my fellow group members on Facebook, I'm going to make a quick tutorial on how to do a wraparound porch. I'm going to show you the simplest way. I'm going to go with a really simple shape for a house. So, we're going to start out with a rectangular shape here. I'm going to overlap some walls. It's just the shape that I'm looking for. We're going to remove those walls afterwards. Then I'm going to put on that wider rectangle. Again, we're joining these rooms. Then we're going to take another one here. About 4 tiles wider, really, however wide you'd like. And we're going to put that on the side of the house. So this is the general shape that we're looking for. And actually, I'm going to bring that all the way back. Okay? Make this even simpler. So here we've got 3 tiles for our porch, which is a decent size. Then upstairs, we're going to copy the same shape. You may not want to do this, you may want to change it up. That's absolutely fine. It still works. Then we're going to take this custom room tool. We're going to click at the corner of the house here, and we're going to come 3 tiles out from this corner. Do the same thing over here. 3 tiles and bring it all the way around, just like that. At that point, we're going to bring this up onto a foundation so we actually have need for a porch. Grab a spandrel. I'm going to use these ones from, I think that's Strangerville. Yeah, Strangerville. I'm going to replace the walls with the spandrels. We are going to add pillars. Again, I'm using the ones from Strangerville. I'm going to create an area here for the entry. This may look weird for a second, but it'll make sense. Do the same thing here. Then here, and put in 2 more pillars. Let's grab some stairs. I'm going to use these treadworthy stairways. These are a base game item. Tuck it all the way in so you don't have the landing, and pull it out to the right so that you have a 3-wide stair. Then we're going to do the same thing with that. Tuck that in right there. If you didn't know this, you can hit this button here and that will copy whatever asset you're holding. Now, let's grab a fence. We're going to also use the same one from Strangerville. I like cohesive builds. We're going to keep it on replace fences and click each one of these gray boxes to create the fence for the porch. We're also going to want to add a stair rail on both stairways. Mind you, I could have done that at first. I just forgot. So now we're going to come upstairs. This is where it gets fun. So we're going to grab the half-hip roof, put it in the corner, pull it out all the way. Don't forget to bring out the eaves. We're going to use a medium height just because it tends to look better. Bring this down to your desired height, and then you're going to copy. Actually, before we do that, let's put on our roof trim so we don't even have to copy that. Use that, and let's say we're going to start out with a scalloped shingled roof. Then again, we're going to hit copy, put it to the corner. And then we're going to pull it all the way out to this corner. Copy it again. do the same thing here and tuck this into the right size. Now, I don't love this angle here. You might not mind it, so you can keep it. But just for my preference, I like to kind of hide that. So I put one of the, what is this here? The half gabled roof. Bring it down to the correct height. We're going to put our trim on it. And the roof pattern that we chose. And we're going to copy that. Bring it around here to the front. And tuck it in. So it just makes kind of a neater finish in that corner. So then I'll just show you really quickly how I would, you know, kind of roof this. So I don't love when houses are this flat at the front. It tends to look a little boring. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a little outcrop. It's not going to be much. Go 4 tiles from either side. Pull it out 2. Just like that. And then we're going to do the same thing up here. I guess I cannot add today. Because that's only 3 on that side. Okay. That's 4. Bring that out like this. Just so it looks a little bit more interesting. Visually. So now we're going to roof this. And I'll show you how to do that. So we're going to grab the half-hipped roof again. This time we're going to pull out the eaves on the front and the sides. Pull it to the width here. Bring it back all the way to here. And we're going to choose our height. I usually like to go down about 4 clicks. Then we're going to copy this right to the back and just resize it as needed. Yeah. And we're going to grab the hip through. Pull it to here. Pull it down to the right height. And then one more. Yep. Pull it all the way back. And then we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to copy that roof. Make it the correct size. Pull it all the way to the side here. It kind of blends everything in. And this one, we're going to bring the same way, so it blends everything in. Then you just put on your roof trim. And shingles. And there you go. A house with a wraparound porch to enjoy these beautiful scenic Henford-on-Badley views. If there's anything else you guys want to see or any other tutorials you might like, let me know. Back.